part of this section shows that government in the new right perspective. Now we change the duties and functioning of the government here. Now, individual, he is the decision maker, confront the possibilities and opportunities here. So, to overcome the opportunities and possibilities in the world event, a type of strategy, a different type of strategy taken by the individual, how it afford to him. Once more, that is the new role here, that the individual act as a decision maker, that is in some time he confronted, he defeated the opportunities and possibilities in the world of event. In that situation, he introduced a particular strategy. The strategy's importance is that this strategy, it may be afforded to him. Otherwise, he cannot choose here. That is known as, here there is a new, there is government in the new right perspective. There is a particular strategy introduced by the individual which is afforded. So that is the best strategy adopted him. Based on this important technique, four important assumptions are introduced by this new important concept. There are four important assumptions here. One is that rationality, and second is self-interest, and third is maximizing strategy, and fourth is replacement. Not replacement, the level of information. So these are the four important assumptions here based on new right perspective. There is a new right perspective is that government introduced the individual, the decision making based on a well developed strategy. This strategy, this is afforded to the individual here. Which are the four important assumptions here? One is the rationality, you are so familiar about the rationality. And secondly, the self-interest. This also may be studied in the previous class. And third is that maximizing strategy. What is meant by maximizing strategy? There are a particular strategy introduced here. Maximizing in the case of satisfaction and maximizing in the case of profit. Both the strategy. Thus, individual got maximum satisfaction. At the same time, these institutions attain maximum profit. All these two components are included here. That is known as maximizing strategy. And fourth is that the level of information, if there is the level of information of individual citizens. That is information attained by each and every individual, it become perfect or this is more appropriate. These are the four important assumptions. So government introduced a new right perspective. What is the new right perspective and what about its assumption? Now we conclude here which are the important criticism of public choice theory. Which are the important criticism? Last part. One important criticism is public interest. Second is market exchange. And third, efficiency. And fourth, no sympathy. Last, early stages of development. The role of government. These are the important criticism of public choice theory. What are the important criticisms here? First is, you are so familiar about public interest. So according to public choice theories, argue that public interest merely the sum of individual self-interest. This is unfair. Does not take into account other factors. This is only or merely the sum of individual self-interest. This is unfair in character. So this is the first important criticism. That the word public interest, not that it is taken only the mere interest of, for, that is self-interest, that is mere interest of the self-individuals or self-interest. This is not fair in character. That the first important criticism. And second is that market exchange. Market exchange is the another important feature of public choice theory. But this is only simply, there is no serious to say about market exchange. This is already you study here, what about the market exchange? So this is too simple in the case of the public choice theory. There is no valid recommendation here. And third is that efficiency. The government act in efficiency, wherever you follow the government efficiency, this is completely against equality, equity and welfare principle. Government act is a creator of, that is in the case of equality, efficiency, sorry, equality, equity and welfare, this was completely against efficiency, does not promote the welfare. And fourth is that no sympathy. That is, in that case, when the government applied the market principle, this was not considered, the sympathetic rich who are not afforded here. And that is, in that case, does not consider no sympathy who are not actors, who are not afforded here. Complete mechanical, complete marketing behavior. And lastly, that in the early stages of development, here there is an absence of private sector. In that case, government act is an important actor of development. That is, in the early stages of development, here there is a not so much importance to the private sector, or private sector is not strong, or the developments are distributed by the government here. So these are the five important criticisms here. One is that public interest, second market exchange, third efficiency, no, fourth is that no sympathy, and last is that early stages of development, private sector is not strong. So government act is an important role that government act is an important role for the development. These are the five important criticism. Now we conclude the public choice theory, beginning from what is the meaning here, assumptions here, then what about theoretical background, what the main points of the, that is the theory, like traditional public interest theory, and last, what are the important criticism. Okay. Hello dear students, നിങ്ങൾക്ക് എന്തെങ്കിലും സംശയങ്ങളൊക്കെ ഉണ്ടെങ്കിൽ നിങ്ങൾ ആ കമൻറ്റ് ബോക്സിലിടുക. അതായത് എന്തെങ്കിലും നിങ്ങൾക്ക് ക്ലാരിഫിക്കേഷൻ വേണം, മനസ്സിലാവാത്ത എന്തെങ്കിലും കാര്യങ്ങളുണ്ട്, അല്ലെങ്കിൽ മിസ് മലയാളത്തിൽ പറഞ്ഞു തരേണ്ട എന്തെങ്കിലുമൊക്കെ ഉണ്ടെങ്കിൽ നിങ്ങൾ എന്ത് ചെയ്യണം, നിങ്ങൾ ആ കമൻറ്റ് ബോക്സിൽ കമൻ്റ് ഇടുക. ഇനി ഇതിൻ്റെ നോട്ട്സ് ഞാൻ ഡിസ്ക്രിപ്ഷൻ ബോക്സിൽ കൊടുത്തിട്ടുണ്ടാവും. നിങ്ങൾ ചാനലിൽ നോക്കിക്കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ നിങ്ങൾക്ക് കിട്ടുക ഡിസ്ക്രിപ്ഷൻ ബോക്സിൽ. ഞാൻ അതാത് ദിവസങ്ങളെ ക്ലാസ് എടുത്തതിൻ്റെ നോട്ട്സ് കൊടുത്തിട്ടുണ്ടാവും.